Welcome students, today we are going to start with the topic of ledger. What do you mean by ledger? It is a principal book. It contains all the accounts which are to be debited or credited. For each account, we open a separate account on a separate page. For example, if we have to make Ram account, it will be on page number 1, and if we have to make Mohan account, it will be on page number 2. No two accounts on one page, right? This account will show the net result of all the transactions. Suppose we have got 10 transactions for Ram. All these transactions, whether debit or credit, will give the net result of Ram account on one page. Now, big companies allot codes instead of particular page, they allot codes. This account is in T shape, on one side debit, on another side credit. Debit side contains date, particulars, journal folio, an amount, and similarly all these four columns are present on the credit side also. Debit entries are recorded on the debit side with a prefix 2, and credit entries are recorded on the credit side with a prefix by. Now let us understand few things with the help of multiple choice questions. Ledger folio in the journal is used for what purpose? A. Record the date of posting. B. Record the number of ledger accounts. C. Record the number of amount posted. And D. Record the page number of ledger account. Yes, the answer is D. We record the page number of the ledger account. Next question. Entry to record the credit sale is A. Debit debtor, credit cash. B. Debit cash, credit debtors. C. Debit cash, credit capital. And D. Debit debtors and credit the sales. Yes, again the option is D, because when we make a sales entry, it is party account debit to sales. Let's see another one. Transactions are properly recorded for A. When only two accounts are used to record. B. One account is used to record. C. One account increase and the other decrease. And the last one is total debit is equal to total credits. Yes, this is the right option, because when we record a transaction, all the debits are equal to credits, as we have already told you in the accounting equation. Yes, the next question is, transactions properly recorded. A. When only two accounts are used to record. B. When one account is used to record. And C. One account increases and the other decreases. And total debit is equal to total credit. Yes, the right option is D part, because as we have told you in accounting equation, all the debits are equal to all the credits. Now, let us understand the difference between journal and ledger. Journal, here we record the entry for the first time, and after that we record it in the ledger. So, we can say in ledger it is second entry, in journal it is first entry. Next point, in journal we record in chronological order, that is date wise order, but in case of ledger we record in analytical manner. Analytical means all the entries relating to a particular person, to a particular group, is recorded at one place. Like Ram entries are recorded in Ram account, Shyam entry are recorded in Shyam account. So, here we are analyzing on the basis of a particular person. Next, journal is called journalizing, and in ledger it is called posting. So when we record in journal, it is journalizing. When we record in ledger, it is called posting. Next, journal is a very important source entry, so it is legal. From legal point of view, it is very important. So if there is any case, so this will be a legal evidence journal, whereas ledger is less in legal evidence. So when we compare both of them, journal will come on the top, right? Now let us classify the ledger accounts. There are two types of account: permanent accounts and temporary accounts. Permanent account are those accounts which are carried forward in the balance sheet for the next period, whereas temporary accounts are those which are closed either in trading account or in profit and loss account. For example, if furniture is there, it will be carried forward to the next year. Building carry forward to the next year. So these are permanent accounts, whereas wages, salary, office expense, all these are temporary accounts. Wages is transferred to trading account, salary is transferred to profit and loss account. Now all these things, trading, P&L, balance sheet, will come in the chapters to come. So right now we are just trying to tell you where they are going. Now why this classification is relevant? This classification is relevant for preparing financial statements. So let me tell you what are the financial statements. We prepare trading account to get gross profit. We prepare profit and loss account to get net profit. And we prepare balance sheet to get assets and liability and the position of the company as at a particular date. Now these will be discussed in detail in the chapter of final accounts to come. Now what is posting? Posting means when we transfer the entry from journal to ledger. We have to locate the accounts which are to be debited or credited. Then we have to write date, particulars, journal folio and amount. For example, if there is an entry of rent paid, in rent account on the debit side we will write to cash, whereas in cash account we will write on the credit side by rent. Now we will take a full question and tell about what will be the journal entry and how the ledger accounts will be prepared. Let us take the first point. Started business with cash 5 lakh. In this case, the entry will be cash account debit and capital account credit. So when we will make cash account, we will write on the debit side to capital, and in the capital account we will write by cash, right? One debit and one credit. Let us see the next entry. Opened a bank account with Syndicate Bank for 80,000. Now I am depositing cash in Syndicate Bank. So my bank account debit and cash account credit. So what journal entry I will make is bank account debit to cash account. So this will be 80,000. In bank account, I will write on the debit side to cash 80,000, and in the cash account, I will write on the credit side by bank 80,000. Let's see the next entry. Goods purchased on credit from Gulmohar 30,000. So I am purchasing the goods from Gulmohar 30,000. So purchase account debit to Gulmohar company 30,000. So the purchase account will say to Gulmohar 30,000 and Gulmohar account will say by purchase 30,000, right? Let's see the next one. Purchase office machine by check 20,000. So the entry will be office machine account debit 20,000 to bank account 20,000. So in the office machine account, we will be writing to bank 20,000, and in the bank account, we'll be writing by office machine 20,000. Next, paid rent by check 5,000. In this case, the entry will be rent account debit to bank account. In the rent account, we will be writing to bank, and in the bank account, we'll be writing by rent. Next, sale of goods on credit to Mohit Brothers 10,000. So the entry will be Mohit Brothers account debit to sales 10,000. In Mohit account, I will be writing to sales 10,000, and in the sales account, we are writing by Mohit Brothers 10,000. Next, cash sales 15,000. The entry will be cash account debit to sales 15,000. In the cash account, we will be writing to sales 15,000, and in the sale account, we'll be writing by cash 15,000. Next, cash paid to Gulmohar 30,000. Entry is Gulmohar account debit to cash 30,000. In the Gulmohar account, to cash 30. In the cash account, by Gulmohar 30. Next, received a check from Mohit Brothers 10,000. Bank account debit to Mohit Brothers 10,000. In the bank account, to Mohit Brothers 10,000. In Mohit account, by bank 10,000. Next, salary paid in cash 6,000. So this will be salary account debit to cash 6,000. In the salary account, we will be writing to cash 6,000, and in the cash account, by salary 6,000. So students, in these sessions, we have completed chapter 3. All these sessions, we have discussed about what is journal, what is voucher, what are the journal entries, what is ledger account, how do we do the entries, how do we post them in the ledger, and so on. And in the next session, we are going to start with the new chapter number 4, which is recording of transaction part 2. So till then, enjoy yourself. Thank you very much.